The fourth myth goes something like this. Abortion is here to stay, people say, right? It's a constitutional right. It's been determined. The law has spoken. The courts have spoken. So let's stop exhausting ourselves with our divisions on abortion, causing unnecessary division, and let's just pursue unity and work together on other important issues. This is the perspective of people who frankly admit to a certain degree of what they call fetus fatigue. People who are just sick and tired of the abortion debate. Some pro-lifers have used this term. Certainly pro-aborts use this term. I'm just tired of the debate. I'm fatigued talking about it. I don't care anymore. Let's focus on something where we can find common ground and unity and accomplish something together. Because that's real progress, right? Real progress is ignoring the fact that an entire class of human beings are being denied the first and most important of all rights. Let's just pretend they don't exist, right? As Hadley Arkus says, let's filter them out of sight. And the example from this week is John Kasich, right? He's the former governor of Ohio, who just last week was on an interview with Meghan McCain, the only conservative on that garbage program, The View. And she asks him why he's willing to support Joe Biden, because John Kasich has come out and said that he's going to vote for Joe Biden. He supports Joe Biden. In fact, he spoke at the virtual DNC saying we were at a crossroads, and he was literally standing at a crossroads. And he said, we need to support Joe Biden because he fights for the soul of the country. You know, he needs to unify us. This is the message, right? Ignore the dismembered bodies of babies who it is currently legal to kill, and let's maintain the appearance of unity on other issues. So when asked what he thought about being pro-life but supporting the most radical pro-abortion ticket in American history that promotes abortion through the day of birth and promises to use your tax dollars to fund it, he says, well, I disagree with Joe Biden in a number of areas. I don't like some of what he's talking about in capital gains taxes. But the issues here are dwarfed, in my opinion, by the fact that he's a person that can pull us together. So listen to what he said, right? He's asked a question specifically and exclusively about abortion, and he starts talking about capital gains taxes. He's creating a moral equivalency between disagreements over taxes and disagreements over slaughtering babies in the womb, right? He's asked a question on abortion. He said, well, I disagree with Joe Biden on a number of issues, you know, like taxes. But the issues, plural here, are dwarfed by the fact that he's a person that can pull us together, right? So unity over the bodies of murdered babies. Tax rates is morally equivalent to abortion. He says, so I do think that if he wins, that all of a sudden, all these things that are going to happen are negative. Do I think that? No, I don't believe that at all, because that's not his character. That is not who he is. He's trying to convince squishy pro-lifers that Joe Biden is not a radical, that he's not just a puppet that Kamala Harris will be operating until that puppet falls apart and she becomes the president of the United States. He's trying to convince people that Joe Biden is a safe vote because he's going to pull us together, right? So murdered babies just become an acceptable sacrifice for the appearance of unity. Now, people accused Lincoln, right, the great anti-slavery, the great abolitionist president, of causing unnecessary division by making too much of slavery. People could have told him that they were, that, you know, they had slave fatigue. Ah, stop talking about slavery so much, Lincoln, I'm over it. Same types of critiques, by the way, from the same party, holding the same bigoted view of persons, that not all of them are persons. And people accuse Abraham Lincoln of treating slavery as a litmus test of the republic, as sort of a gauge of the moral compass of the country. But we understand that such division was important and necessary to pursue justice and ensure that the promises of the Declaration were granted to all human beings. That division had to happen, you see, because it was unacceptable that the institution of slavery was being allowed to operate and being praised and expanded by the Democratic Party in a republic founded upon the idea of natural rights.